Hi everyone, and welcome to Dolphin Amphitheater, home to 16 bottlenose dolphins ranging in age from 3 to 38 years old. Now we love to care for these animals and celebrate each and every day with them. So are you ready to meet us? Oh, is this a full stadium? Are you ready to meet some dolphins? Alright, well here they are. Coming out first, we have our largest dolphin at over 700 pounds, along with one of her best friends, coming out to show you their cute little faces. This is Melanie and Koa. Next up, she's our California girl, and she's as smart as she is pretty. Coming around the perimeter of the pool, give it up for Malibu. And last, but certainly not least, she's one of our most athletic dolphins. She'll be coming out to the center of the pool to show you just how high she can jump. This is Captain! And we can't forget about our team of dedicated trainers who care for these dolphins every day. Say hello to Brian, Tiffany, MJ, and I'm Destiny. Ladies and gentlemen, these animals have a ton of energy and they love to have fun. So let's watch as they show us how they celebrate life.
Great one. an amazing start to the show. Now, in just a few moments, we're going to have another trainer down by the glass, and we are going to tell you a little bit about our personal story and how we build relationships with the dolphins. We hope you folks are enjoying watching these beautiful dolphins, and we have lots more to come. Dusty, can you tell us more?
Hey, Sis. All right, guys. So my name's Dusty. I've been a trainer here at SeaWorld for 4 years. But my love for the ocean and its animals started a long time ago. I grew up right here along our Southern California coast, exploring tide pools and watching dolphins from the shore. But it was coming to SeaWorld where I gained a true understanding and appreciation of the animals that live in the ocean. I knew I wanted to dedicate my life to caring for these animals too. When I was 16, after a show right here in this amphitheater, my parents helped me build up the courage to come down and ask a trainer what I needed to do to make my dreams come true. I also learned that day that SeaWorld is a world leader in animal care, rescue, and rehabilitation. So I knew that this was a perfect fit for me. So how do you build a relationship with a 500-pound dolphin? Just take a look behind me. We spend time with them. These animals all have their own personalities, their own likes and dislikes, their own way of doing things. And it's up to us to spend that time building the relationship, trust, and bond it takes to care for them and enrich their lives too. So you see Brian just kind of rubbing down our dolphins there. They're making squeaks and squeals. They're doing that all on their own. They're fun and excited noises that they're making to just kind of let us know that they're having a good time too. And we learn that about each of them. Now these animals are amazing ambassadors for SeaWorld. And the reason why my new friend here gets to meet a dolphin today. Hi, what's your name, sweetheart? Lisa, nice to meet you. Where are you from? San Diego, all the way from San Diego. All right. Come on up these steps here. We get to meet Captain today. Hi, Miss Captain. Let's put our hands up and give her a big hello. There you go. Very good. All right, now fingers like this, and we're going to listen while you bounce them up and down. You bounce them, and she's going to sing. Hear her? Perfect. That's coming out of her blowhole on top of her head. That's where they make all their sounds from. Now, Lisa, I'm going to lay her out in front of us. You reach in, give her some love right there. Now we're down on her back. What does she feel like? Very soft. Dolphins are very smooth and sleek in the water. All right, let's get her some snacks. She's having a good time here. Ooh, we got a squid and a capelin. Don't be afraid. You just, they like it when you squish it in your hands there. Just squish it real good. There you go. We got a couple more squid here. 41 for each hand, Lisa. Here, the other hand. This squid has to be from the other hand. Good girl. All right, come on down here. We do have a little problem, though. Smell those hands. Ooh, kind of fishy, right? That's okay. Trainers know how to get rid of that smell. Take your hands like this, slap them together, and you rub really fast. Get them nice and warm. Peel them apart. Just rub them on that pretty shirt. See? The smell goes away. No big deal. All right. Now, Lisa, I'm going to have you face the crowd because you're kind of a celebrity now. We're going to wave to them, and Captain's going to wave behind you with her tail because she doesn't have hands. So you wave to the audience. I'm going to get out of your picture because I don't want to be in the way. Oh, Lisa, what's happening? What happened over there? What did you do? All right. Well, Captain does that to people she likes. So we're going to send her that way. Lisa, I'm going to have you come over this way. It's our hope that your generation shares in our passion for marine mammals. Let's hear it for Lisa and Captain. All right, you guys. Well, now you've gotten to meet some of our dolphins. But there's another animal that lives in our dolphin home. It's time to meet our short fin pilot whales. Now, pilot whales can be found throughout our global ocean and are a close relative to both dolphins and killer whales. We have the privilege of working with two pilot whales here. Argo is 18 years old, and he was a rescue after being found stranded on a beach in Japan. He lived there for about 8 years with other dolphins, but we wanted to get him with some animals of his species. So about 5 years ago, he joined our family. He's been here ever since and continues to thrive, right alongside his best friend, Shadow. Shadow is 38 years old. And not only does she love interacting with Argo and her dolphin friends, but she loves interacting with her trainers. In fact, because of her kind and patient personality, when trainers first start working with pilot whales, Shadow is the whale they start with. Now, pilot whales too have a zest for life. They are playful and curious, and we want them to be able to relate to us and vice versa. Now keep in mind, when they come out here, soak zone, these are 2,000 pound whales and they can move some water. So if you want to stay dry, this is your chance to move on up. But when they come out, you'll see that playtime is their favorite and one of the best ways to build our relationship with them. So let's watch as LJ and Argo and Andre and Shadow enjoy a fun moment together. Our skies and all of their amazing animals. Right, everyone?
ground.